Welcome to Stafford County Showground on a bright but blustery autumn day. Now the focus this weekend is going to be centred round a familiar face to regular viewers, judging all the groups and best in show. Now I'll warn you, the next hour is going to be full of sensational dogs. We're here at Midland County's Championship Dog Show for Around the Dog World. At Midland County's 2015, we've got loads to fit in, all the groups and best in show judged by our very own Andrew Brace. But before that, we need to fill in the blanks since our last outing at Darlington Championship Dog Show, and we've found a nice cosy little corner of the Stafford Agricultural Society Presidential Suite to meet Di Johnson. Nice cosy spot, Di.
Yes, isn't it? Posh.
You might remember last time out, we watched Tyler the Bulldog winning best in show at Darlington under Albert White. Yeah. Another Scotswoman, was judging best in show in Belfast.
Yeah.
And Tyler goes and does it again.
Yeah. And great for dogs, because what a healthy, happy, fit, lively bulldog he is.
And we should mention, he nearly made it three in a row.
Yeah.
He reserved best in show at Richmond the week before Darlington.
So yes, he was
on an incredible run of form.
Yes, it is.
The week later, he took a trip to Driffield. The winner there was Alaska Malamute Bart. He's in the top 10 top dogs all this year. Won the Crufts Working Group, and the same judge awards him best in show.
Well, understandably. What a big, handsome, sound, strong dog he is.
I think there's only been three Alaska Malamute best in show winners, all of which Sue Ellis's.
Time and time again, she brings out good dogs.
The last general championship show we have to visit is South Wales. And almost incredibly, this dog's very first all-breed best in show in the UK, King the Wire Fox Terrier.
Yes, and I'm delighted because I've looked at him winning all over the world and think, why isn't he doing this here? I was delighted, and especially Wales.
Yes, but Welsh handled, but Brazilian and Belgian owned and Belgian bred. He's a very
still people of my generation put terriers down to Wales.
The last show we've got to visit is just a single group. This is Gundog Society, again in Wales. Val Foss awards Juicy, the Pointer, best in show.
Do you remember Mr. Brace giving her best of breed here? She won the group under Tamás Yackel in this very hall. And you and I have loved her and delighted to see her get her just rewards.
Yes. Well, that brings us up to this show. Now, you know Andrew Brace quite well. You've watched him judge a few times.
Yeah.
What can we expect from Andrew this weekend?
I tell you, Andrew is going to do this. It's going to be an object lesson in judging. He's going to find the best dogs. We're going to be impressed by Andrew Brace, I promise.
I'm looking forward to it.
Bet we don't disagree.
Probably not, no. Well, thank you very much, Di. So we need a few words with the man of the moment, Andrew Brace. Now, normally on the programme, Andrew, you're passing judgment on other people's decisions in the group ring. This weekend, you get to make all the major decisions.
Yes, I suppose I do, don't I? Yes, very exciting.
You must have been looking forward to this for a very long time.
Yeah, I have. I mean, the invitation came in about 3 years ago, and obviously I was very grateful to Midland Counties for giving me it. Yeah, it is an honour, obviously. The few days before I came up, it suddenly dawned on me, and I thought, yes, I'm not ashamed to say I was excited about it. My first set of CCs I awarded in 1977, Pekingese at Welks. My first toy group was at Bath in 1981, and then my first best in show appointment was 1988, which was at the South Wales Kennel Association. So that is 27 years ago.
Do you still remember that first best in show vividly?
Absolutely. A Pekingese champion, Johnsville daytime lover. Reserve was an English Springer bitch, Rondeau Jemima Jones.
I think you can probably run through all of your best in show winners like that.
Pretty much. Pretty much.
Now, you have nearly 200 breeds to judge this weekend.
Mm-hmm.
How do you prepare for something like that?
Well, when you've been judging for the length of time that I have, you have a basic template in your head of the ideal picture on all the breeds, basically. But if, for example, a breed is scheduled that I don't judge regularly, then I will check the breed standard for things like, you know, minor things like eye shape, bites, that kind of stuff. Something that might not necessarily be, you know, in the brain bank.
Across seven groups, are you looking for different things in those groups?
Your priorities change a little. For example, if it was a toy breed and it was if the dentition was a little untidy, then I wouldn't be throwing the baby out with the bathwater. However, you know, a dentition fault in a gun dog breed, for example, I would be harder on.
And that's due to the function of the breed?
Yeah, because they have to do a job of work.
Now, over the past few years of filming, we often mention a dog as a big ring dog.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think dogs perform differently in breed rings and group rings?
To an extent, they do. You know, sometimes they do actually grow a little bit. And of course, the other thing is, when you get into the group, you have a ring that's four times the size of the breed ring.
Yeah.
So the dogs that have the capacity to be outstanding movers, they can take full advantage of that big ring.
Well, thank you, Andrew. I'm looking forward to the weekend ahead.
So am I.
I'm sure everyone watching at the group ring will be tonight.
Let's hope so.
The first group of the night is the utility group, judged by...
Ask Mrs. Johnson, she'll have his name.
We'll double check it. It's the utility group.
The Keyshorn, exhibit number 2085. The Lazarabzo, 2151. The Miniature Schneiser, 2305. The Standard Poodle, 2371.
One through.
The Schnauzer, 2388. The Sahel, 2438. The Miniature Poodle, 2812. Remaining in the ring is the Keyshund, Standard Poodle, the Sarpe, and the Miniature Poodle. Let's hear your applause and appreciation for the Keyshund, the Standard Poodle, the Sarpe, and the Miniature Poodle. And Group 1 goes to the Keyshund, Group 2 to the Standard Poodle, Group 3 to the Sarpe, and Group 4 to the Miniature Poodle.
Winner of the utility group, the first group, was Harry the Keyshund. Mm-hmm. David, you've got to be very pleased. This is the first group for him.
It's the first group win for him, yes. He's won his second challenge certificate here today.
Wow.
And he also went best in show at the club show earlier on this month.
Wow.
So, yeah, it's been a very good month.
How old is he?
He's 2.5.
Right. And as a Keyshund, would you expect him to be coming into his own now?
Yes, he's coming into his prime. Funnily enough, he's not in full coat at the moment, which is interesting. But no, he's certainly got a lot of promise ahead of him.
What makes him a good one?
His overall construction movement, you know, he's got a typical Keyshund head, what they should have. Yes. It should be fox-like expression.
What's he like to handle in there?
Beautiful. He's a lovely dog. He's very responsive to me all the time.
And you've got to come back on Sunday.
Yes.
You've got a few days to recuperate.
Yes.
What does Harry need now?
He's going to have plenty of rest for the next couple of days. His owner's been informed that she's not allowed to do any stressful work with him. So he's going to hopefully come back fresh on Sunday.
The Bichon Frise, exhibit number 85. The Lonco Chihuahua, exhibit number 295. The Smooth Coated Chihuahua, 1411. The English Toy Terrier, 629. The Italian Greyhound, 773. The Japanese Chin, 800. The King Charles Spaniel, 927. The Laotian, 946. The Maltese, 973. The Papillon, 1145.
Andrew's now seen all the dogs in his toy group, but who is going home a winner? Find out after the break.
Pulled out again, we have the Bichon Frise, the long coat chihuahua, Japanese chin, and the Laotian. Let's hear your appreciation for the long coat chihuahua, the Bichon Frise, the Laotian, and the Japanese chin. Group one. Group two is the Laotian. Group three, the Bichon Frise. And the Japanese chin is group four.
Well, Leslie, last time we were out, Darlington, Geoffrey not only took a group, but he took reserve best in show. We're out again and we see you winning yet another group. You must be over the moon.
Oh, I'm absolutely. I just don't know what to say anymore. He's just excelled himself once again. Just done his stuff as usual.
Yeah.
And what can I say? I've said it all before. He's just absolutely fantastic.
He's a little star in that ring, isn't he?
Oh, he loves it. He really does. I mean, he just feeds off the crowd, and he's got quite a little following, actually. So, yeah. You know, out of the breed as well. So yeah. That's really...
And Andrew's one of them.
Yeah, he is now.
You've got a couple of days now. What does Geoffrey need in the days in between group win and best in show ring?
He will go home, obviously, and he'll just chill out and do what he usually does, which is laying on the sofa.
The toy group being such a competitive one, all these wins must be so special.
That, well, any win's special, you know, whether you're leading up to the top toy position or not.
Yeah.
You know, I come into the ring the same every time, hoping that I'll get a placing. And when he does it, that, you know, that's enough for me. It really is.
Well, thank you very much for talking to us, and see both you and Geoffrey on Sunday night.
Yes, thank you.
Well, there we are. Had the first two groups on Midland Counties 2015. It was day one, Di.
Yep.
We started in the utility group.
Yep.
What did you make of Andrew's performance, first of all?
Well, it was very serious, very professional. No playing about. He was determined to do it well, and he did.
Yeah.
It was a nice group, and he found a caisson that was totally up for the job. And he really showed well, thought it was a super dog, and I thought Andrew was very dignified and competent.
Andrew, dignified and competent. Does that sound good to you? Mrs. Johnson.
They aren't adjectives that get thrown at me very often. who came up with that one? She's biased.
Is she?
Just a tad, yes. Yeah. She's a very good friend and loyal supporter, but she, in this instance, she's actually correct, of course.
What did you make of your utility group winning the caisson?
What did I make of... Well, it wasn't an easy group to judge, because the caisson wasn't like one of the immediate flash and dash dogs. But as soon as he came in the ring, I looked at him and I thought, you know, he's very correct. His forehand right down to the spectacles. Up and down, nothing amiss at all. Fabulous body, good coat texture.
We'll go back to Mrs. Johnson briefly. Toy group winner, Geoffrey.
Geoffrey, we know. Never does anything wrong, does it? All the attitude of a chow. I thought the toy group was exceptional.
On the last programme, I said that you were a fully paid-up member of Geoffrey's fan club, and you go and give him the group.
I mean, you know, why pretend I've never seen the dog before? I've given him best of breed. I've admired him in groups on several occasions. I've talked about him on the programme. Even in a group of that quality, he was pretty much a standout because he's a little bit of a showman, but he's so sensible, and behind him came half a dozen really, really good dogs.
Welcome back to Around the Dog World on day two of Midland County's Championship Dog Show 2015. It's a quiet one today, just one group. And once again, Andrew Brace is our judge of the Gundog group.
Bracco Italiano. The English setter. The German Y-head pointer. The Gordon setter. The Hungarian Bischoff. The Irish red and white setter. The pointer. The flat-coated retriever. The Labrador retriever. The American Cocker Spaniel. Cocker Spaniel. The English Springer Spaniel. The Irish Water Spaniel. The Welsh Springer Spaniel. The Spanish Water Dog. The Weimarana. The Wire Hair. Isla. Pointer, flat coat, American Cocker, Welsh Springer, Cocker Spaniel. Pointer, flat coat, American Cocker, Welsh Springer, Cocker Spaniel. Your appreciation for those leaving the ring. The pointer, the Irish red and white, the Cocker Spaniel, and the Welsh Springer. And the winner is the pointer. Group two, the Irish red and white. Group three, the Cocker Spaniel. And group four, the Welsh Springer Spaniel.
Sam and Juicy, well, this hole under Andrew Brace has been rather lucky for you.
Very lucky, yeah. Very lucky.
Other end of the hole, they gave you best of breeds, and later on that day, you won a group and a reserve Aston show.
Yeah.
And he's given you a group before.
Yes, last year, August at SKC. Her first group, so yeah, she's gone on from there.
And she's on some amazing form. Is she top gun dog at the moment?
I think she's top gun dog now, yeah. I'm not really taking any notice of it, but yeah, no, I think she is top gun dog.
Are you trying to ignore that? Does that create a bit of pressure?
No, I just want to enjoy showing her and have no pressure, so, yeah.
What do you do to get her performing for you every single time?
I think she just loves it. I think she just loves to please. And she just loves a big ring, loves a crowd.
Yeah.
And obviously it gets better as the group, the ring gets better and bigger, and she just loves it.
And she eats up the ground.
She absolutely does, yeah. She loves it.
She's...
I say go and she goes. So yeah.
She certainly does, and he made you work for it.
He did. He did, as did Frank in the reed. Yeah. I'm absolutely happy.
Well, Andrew, that's your third group of the weekend.
That was so much fun. Did you see the size of the shortlist? The pointer bitch, I've already given her a group. She was my reserve best in show in Scotland. She's in magnificent form. She won under probably one of the greatest pointer experts in the world, Mr. Frank Kane. Her movement is where she really comes into her own.
And you made her work for it.
Yes, I always make them work, and gun dogs have to move. And Miss Dyer, I think, is a much fitter person for having been in that ring for the last hour. The Irish red and white bitch, it was apparently the first time she's ever been placed in a group. She's beautiful, perfectly marked, she moves beautifully. I mean, it was a quartet of outstanding gun dogs, and it was the strongest gun dog group I've ever judged, and I'm extremely happy.
What about this weekend? The best yet?
I'm not going to commit myself on that.
Well, congratulations, Sam. And tomorrow we come back for Hound and Pastoral.
Welcome back to Around the Dog World on day three of Midland County's Championship Dog Show 2015. For the past 2 years here, we've seen Oliver, the Wire Fox Terrier, be crowned Best in Show winner. But there'll be a new name on the trophy this year. The groups today are Hound and Pastoral, and the group judge tonight is Andrew Briss.
The Afghan Hound, 4633. The Basset Hound, 4744. Now the Delena, 4908. The Beagle, 4840. The Long Hair, 4983. Mini Smooth, 5044. Mini Wild, 5157. The Deerhound, 5266. The Greyhound, 5309. Irish Wolfhound, 5339. The Faroe Hound, 5393. The Saluki, 5549. The Whippet, 5753. Our appreciation for the Irish Wolfhound, the Afghan, the Deerhound, the Faroe Hound, the Saluki, the Basset, the Beagle, and the miniature smooth-haired accent. Lords and gentlemen and ladies, thank you. The Afghan Hound, the Beagle, the Basset Hound, and the miniature smooth-haired accent. The Afghan Hound, Group 1, the Beagle 2, Basset Group 3, and the Petite Group 4. Ladies and gentlemen, show your appreciation for our group winner, Group 2, Group 3, and Group 4.
Well, Roberta, congratulations at a group with Barry. Were you expecting that today?
No, certainly not. It was a fantastic win, and I really, really appreciate and value Andrew's opinion. But more so, the bitch is just so lovely to show, and everything she does is just really, really, I'm so grateful.
She glides, doesn't she?
Her movement is her forte. She's a beautiful bitch. She's only 2 years old, so she's got lots more to come. But the main thing is she just goes out there and she sells herself. She just floats around the ring and, you know, I think she's a real winner.
When you walk into a ring, do you take a look around and see what's the best?
I do. I've been... It's 50 years since I had my first Afghan, long, long time. And I always have a look round and see what's in the group ring. And there are dogs, obviously, that have got previous form, and there are dogs that you admire. So, you know, to be amongst them is great, but to actually beat them is fantastic.
She's got a lot of coat. What do you have to do between now and tomorrow?
Tomorrow, well, I'm going home. I live about an hour from here, so it's not too far. Yeah. She'll go straight out in the garden. And she'll be running around, she'll get wet through, she'll go for a walk in the morning, also some free exercise, then I will bath her before I bring her back tomorrow afternoon. But I'm a very great believer in that dogs need free running and exercise for their physical health but also their mental health as well.
The Bearded Collie, exhibit number 6017. The Belgian Shepherd Granada, 6038. Border Collie, 6154. The Rough Collie, 6277. The Hungarian Poolie, 6421. The Old English Dog, 6455. The Pyrenean Mountain Dog, 6516. The Samoyed, 6586. The Shetland Sheepdog, 6729. Pembroke Corgi, 6770. The final look for the Bearded Collie, the Old English Sheepdog, the Samoyed, and the Hungarian Poolie. The winner of the pastoral group, the Bearded Collie. Second, the Old English Sheepdog. Group 3, the Samoyed, and Group 4, the Hungarian Poolie.
Well, Justine and Fame, we've watched you do twice already this year.
Three times. Number four.
Four times this year,
wow. Yes.
She's having a fantastic year.
Yes, absolutely. It's definitely her year, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
A massive entry, 140. Wow. I think one of the highest entries this year, so that was really nice.
Yeah.
And yeah, I mean, what a fantastic group to win as well.
Yeah, and you had a bit of waiting tonight. It was a long one. Does Fame get better as the day goes on?
The more you ask of her, the more she gives, yeah. Yes.
What are you going to have to do to get Fame to give you that little bit more investment?
I think tomorrow morning before we come back, she's going to have to go for a good run, a good blast over the meads with her friends. And I'm coming back tomorrow anyway because my puppy won the puppy stakes today. So it's double.
This is a very good day.
Yes, absolutely.
Fame, we've watched her winning a few groups this year and she was your choice as well.
She's absolutely lovely. And I mean, as soon as she came in the group, to be honest, she went around. She's full of energy, sometimes a little bit too much so. But she's quality, she's beardy, she's sound, she's in beautiful condition. And yeah, I mean, the first four were excellent dogs, but from the start, She was I'm not going to make you big-headed now. She pretty much had it in the bag.
We'll take a look.
A worthy winner. A very, very nice quartet.
So a lovely quartet here. What about your hounds earlier on?
Yeah, the hound group, that was a very strong group again. Now, you see, judging dogs is all about on the day.
Wait,
because
you see the Afghan just behind you, stepping back.
The Afghan bitch, I had her 2 weeks ago. She won the bitch CC under me. She didn't win best of breed. Her litter brother beat her for the breed. So when I pointed to her in the group, I don't know who was more surprised, that she, me or Roberta, but in that big ring today, on the go-around, she gets her head and tail up with that style of high order. You know, she just owned the big ring. Having said that, my original winner was going to be the Beagle Bitch. She's beautiful on the stack, but when I said to them all, go round on loose leads, then she just lost her carriage a little bit. A very good group. I'm beginning to sound like Di Johnson.
You sound like you're having an excellent...
A fabulous show. I'm on adrenaline.
Well, a new expert, Leslie, Andrew's had some cracking groups this weekend.
Yes.
What did you make of that hound group to start with?
The hound group, I love as Afghan. I thought it was steeped with quality, but the Afghan is particularly nice, yes.
And we move on quickly to the pastoral group. Is one of them?
Which is my home group, and yeah. I think probably that is one of the most quality lineups I've seen ever. Right. Wouldn't argue with him for a minute. As he's judging, you can see he's looking, he's nitpicking in a lot of cases, because that's what he has to do.
Now, you've travelled halfway across the world to watch this weekend. How would you compare the quality on two sides of the world?
Well, it's a completely different scenario because we don't have the numbers over there, and a lot of our breeds are as good as you get here. A lot of them aren't as good as you get here. But it balances itself out. Obviously, with us not having the numbers, the quality drops away really quickly. Whereas here, the quality is there in depth, and it's just wonderful to watch.
Welcome back to Around the Dog World on day four of Midland County's Championship Dog Show 2015. We're here today for the climax tonight, Best in Show. But first of all, we need to find two more winners, the first of which from Andrew Brace's Terrier Group.
The Bedlington Terrier, 27942. 7942, the Bedlington Terrier. The Miniature Bull Terrier, 8164. The Dandy Dinmont, 8278. The Irish Terrier, 8306. The Norfolk, 8390. The Norwich, 8410. The Soft Coated Wheaton Terrier, 8536. The Staffordshire Bull Terrier, 8657. The West Highland White Terrier, 8745. The Miniature Bull Terrier, the Irish Terrier, the Norwich Terrier, the West Highland White Terrier. Your applause, please, for these four, one of whom will be the winner of the Terrier Group. And the winner is the Irish Terrier, Group 2, the West Highland White, Group 3, the Norwich, and Group 4, the Miniature Bull Terrier.
Well, John, Ricky does it yet again. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
How many groups has he notched up?
I think that's his eighth group now.
And he's still a very young dog.
Yeah, he's not 2.5 yet, so we're thrilled.
And you've just come out of the Terrier group. He's obviously won Best of Breed earlier. You've got a little bit of a gap. Is that slightly difficult to get him ready again for Best in Show?
No, he should be okay. As soon as he sees the other dogs in the ring, he's on his toes and ready to go, hopefully.
Andrew has loved Ricky in the past. He's judged him before, hasn't he?
Yeah, I had Group 2 at Scotland under him last year. Ricky was only 14 months old, so I was hoping, and we got there.
And that Westie's pushed you hard a few times this year.
Yeah, nice Westie, and I think it will be taking top honours sooner or later.
You know, when they first came in, I thought that young Westie that we got so excited about at Blackpool, I thought she was going to win, and I still love her. She's got it all to come. The Irish, I had him in a group the last time. He was a little bit, he was young and flighty. Today, I don't know whether Johnny'd been working on him particularly. He was so settled. And I have to say, John Avis's presentation of a terrier is second to none. I mean, the dog was just in flawless condition. He never put a foot wrong. And this is just making tonight so difficult because, I mean, I'm just loving these winners. Now, let's get on with the working.
The Bullmaster, 7258. The Doberman, 7287. The German Pinscher, 7454. The Newfoundland, 7663. The Rottweiler, 7731. The Russian Black, 7755. The Saint Bernard, 7764. The Bouvier Vitandre, 7917. Remaining in the ring is the Boxer, the Rottweiler, the Saint Bernard, and the Bouvier Vitandre. Your appreciation for those now leaving the ring. Going around the St. Leonard, the Boxer, the Rottweiler, the Bouvier Vitandre. The winner of the working group is the St. Leonard. Group 2 is the Boxer. Group 3, the Rottweiler. And Group 4, the Bouvier Vitandre. Ladies and gentlemen, Best in Show will be selected from 7 group winners. The first group winner to enter the ring is the Pointer, followed by the Afghan Hound, 4633, the St. Bernard, 7764, the Bearded Collie, the Utility, the Keyshun, the Irish Terrier, maybe little, but got a heart of gold, the non-coated Chihuahua. You can give the encouragement to the group winner that you would like to see be awarded Best in Show. The winner of the Gun Dog, the Pointer, 3494. The winner of the Hound Group, the Afghan Hound, 4633. The winner of the Working Group, the St. Bernard, 7764. Pastoral Group winner, the Bearded Collie, 6017. the utility group winner, the Keys Hund, 2085. The Terrier Group winner, the Irish Terrier, 8306. 8306, the Irish Terrier. The Toy Group winner, the Long Coat Chihuahua, exhibit number 295. You have the Pointer, the Afghan Hound, the St. Bernard, the Bearded Collie, the Keyshund, the Irish Terrier, and the Long Coat Chihuahua. Exhibit number 295 is Best in Show, Midland Counties, and the Bearded Collie is the Reserve Best in Show. Congratulations to all of the group winners. Let's hear it for our Best in Show, the Long Coat Chihuahua, the Reserve Best in Show, the
Well, Andrew, littlest dog, biggest ring, and stole your heart.
I'm going to have to do this without crying. She's going to start me off in a minute.
Both of you.
I mean, seven group winners. I could have given any of them Best in Show. I mean, I loved them all, really. But, I mean, this little dog, he's a phenomenon. You know, he's a once-in-a-lifetime dog. And he never, ever puts a foot wrong on the table, right down to his full mouth with big white teeth in a breed like Chihuahuas, for heaven's sake. It's almost like he's talking to her in the ring. His movement is flawless. He has the correct coat. His head and expression, especially when he's falling asleep in his mother's arms, are enchanting. I mean, he was flawless, simple as that.
And Leslie, you were quite moved by that, weren't you?
Just... it's what your dreams are made of, and it made especially even more special today because Andrew gave me my first ever ticket with a Chihuahua.
Did I really? With Diamond Geezer? I didn't realise that was your first ever CC.
Yeah, well, you just don't expect this sort of thing to happen, and last year was incredible, and I didn't think we could top it.
Did you feel any pressure after last year?
I did, yes. Yeah, because you've got something to prove with him, and, you know... But he's just kept going and going and going. And, I mean, today I was a bag of nerves and he was just fast asleep on the way up here. We had trouble on the M25, thought we weren't going to make it. And, I nearly sort of had a breakdown. But he was fast asleep with his legs up in the air.
Well, congratulations, Geoffrey and Leslie. Andrew, we have to talk to you about your bearded collie, your reserve.
Well, it's type from nose to tail. And I love the way that she went around on that final go-around. You know, slightly low, covering ground, effortless.
And your final group winner of the weekend, standing behind you there, the St. Bernard.
Yeah, this was quite a surprise, actually, because the Bull Mastiff came in, who I've never judged before, but I've admired enormously. And unfortunately, the dog had gone unsound, so very wisely his handler asked to withdraw. And, you know, this St. Bernard, she just flowed and looked as if she could have gone on all day. Absolutely free of exaggeration, put together, moves beautifully. So, yeah, ended up with a nice quartet.
Di, how do you rate it?
I have to say, he performed exactly as I said he would, perfectly correctly. He judged extremely well.
I thought you were talking about the dog.
Well, let's start with him. I was proud of you, Andrew. I thought the dogs...
Don't make me cry.
I thought the Chihuahua, we've always had a soft spot for that Chihuahua, you know, and I thought it was bang on form. I love the Beardy, class. But the Irish was bang on form. It was a lovely lineup, wasn't it?
I mean, I could have gone anywhere.
And let's pay a compliment to Midland Counties. To get dogs as good as this, they've chosen the right judges through the breeds to send these dogs through. So a super show, I thought.
That, of course, is one of the last shows before the end of the year, and Top Dog is crowned. Jeffrey's win has closed in on Travis the Papillon, with Juicy's group win strengthening her grip on third place. Congratulations to Jeffrey. Congratulations to Andrew on judging all of the groups, and we'll see you next time at the Yukonuba Champion Stakes Final.